हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ए के आर केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस। टुडे वी विल डील विथ सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ फिनॉल्स। इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ फिनॉल्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द केमिकल रिएक्शंस ऑफ फिनॉल्स इन्वॉल्विंग ओएच बॉन्ड क्लीवेज एस्पेशली टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस ओएच बॉन्ड क्लीवेज एस्पेशली वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द एसिडिक nature of phenols. The acidic nature of phenols can be explained based on two theories. The first one is based on resonance theory. First, we are going to explain the acidic nature of phenol based on resonance theory. When phenol is treated with water, it involved in the formation of phenoxidion with the loss of proton. Any substance which has an ability to produce H plus ion in aqueous solution, such compounds are acidic compounds. Therefore, phenol is acidic in nature. This is phenol and this is phenoxide ion. The donating capacity of H plus ion, or breaking up of OH bond depends upon the stability of phenoxide as well as phenol. Depends on stability of both phenoxide ion as well as stability of phenol. So first I am going to explain the acidic nature of phenol by using resonating structure of phenol followed by the resonating structures of phenoxide ion. In case of phenol, double bond, this is oxygen and this is hydrogen. So here there are two effects will be there, negative induct effect as well as negative mesomeric effect, and minus R effect is greater than minus I effect. Therefore these electrons will shift towards the benzene ring. Hence, it involved in the formation of resonating structure because benzene is a conjugated system. By donating the electron density, oxygen carries positive charge. By accepting the electron density, this sp2 carbon atom of benzene ring carries negative charge. Now this negative charge delocalized throughout the benzene ring. Delocalized means the movement of electron density in the conjugated system from one atom to another atom. It is not static, but it is in motion. Double bond, negative charge. This negative charge will come here. Now this negative charge will get shifted here. I get one more resonating structure like this. Double bond, negative charge. Double bond O, hydrogen, positive charge. Now it will come here, it will move here. Finally, final structure. I get this final structure, OH. Okay, means due to conjugation of benzene ring, I can represent totally five resonating structures for phenol. Out of five resonating structure, you can observe in three resonating structure the oxygen atom carrying the positive charge. Due to this, oxygen being more electronegative in nature, and if it carries the positive charge, it becomes unstable. Therefore, to retain its stability, it gives out the H plus ion in aqueous solution very easily. Now, coming to the resonating structure of phenoxide ion. Double bond. This is O minus. This negative charge present on the oxygen atom undergo delocalization with the conjugated system of benzene ring. नेगेटिव चार्ज डबल बॉन्ड ओ डबल बॉन्ड नाउ दिस नेगेटिव चार्ज विल शिफ्ट हियर आई गेट वन मोर रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर माइनस this negative charge will come here students and it will move here I get one more resonating structure negative charge double bond O and finally the negative charge move towards oxygen atom double bond single bond O minus here also you can observe there are five resonating structures for phenoxide ion and we taught in the last year reaction mechanism concept that if the stability of intermediate If the stability of intermediate is more or maximum, then its acidic or basic property will be maximum. Means whenever the phenol get converted into phenoxide ion, the phenoxide ion becomes more stable due to the resonance. Which easily supports the release of H plus ion. Which easily supports for the release of H plus ion or for the release of proton from phenol. This is very simple concept. Please note it down. Now the one question arises in the class 12. Phenoxide ion is more stable than phenol. Give reason. We can explain this reason based upon the resonating structures. Now if this electron density will come here. It will move here and it form resonating structure like this. Minus double bond O plus and this is hydrogen. Here if negative charge undergo delocalization, the electrons comes here, this electron will jump here automatically due to conjugation. Negative charge double bond O double bond means In case of phenols also we are getting five resonating structures. In case of phenol I am getting five resonating structures. In case of phenoxide ion also we are getting same number of resonating structures. Because in the last year concepts we taught that for any molecule as the number of resonating structure increases its stability increases. But in here in case of both phenol as well as in case of phenoxide ion the total number of resonating structures are same both phenol and phenoxide ion has an ability to form five resonating structures so based on this I cannot explain the stability of phenol with phenoxide ion so what I will do I'll use this concept what charge separation concept In case of phenol, you can observe here, there is one positive charge is there and there is one negative charge will be there. During resonance, the charge separation takes place. But in case of phenoxide ion, this negative charge delocalized throughout the benzene ring. And there is no charge separation. Whenever the charge separation is possible in the resonating structure, its stability decreases. Either here or here if the negative charge comes automatically it involved in the charge separation with positive due to this charge separation the stability of the resonating structure decreases hence phenoxide ion is more stable than phenol please note it down the question is very simple why phenols are more acidic than alcohols? Why phenols are more acidic than alcohol? Simple answer. When phenol is treated with water, it undergoing dissociation by forming stable resonating structure phenoxidion with the liberation of H plus ion in aqueous solution. Means both phenol as well as phenoxidion. This is phenoxidion. It involved in the formation of stable phenoxidion. Stable phenoxidion. Due to the formation of stable phenoxidion, forward reaction favors in nature. Always forward reaction favor in nature means more number of H plus ion can be produced. In case of alcohol, when alcohol is treated with water, it undergo dissociation by producing alkoxide ion with the release of proton. But the obtained alkoxide ion is unstable. The obtained alkoxide ion is highly unstable. Due to this unstability of alkoxide ion, it readily accepts the proton. It readily accepts the proton from water molecule to form alcohol. Means in this case, backward reaction favor in nature. In this case, forward reaction is favor. In this case, backward, because the obtained alkoxide ion is not stable. But here, the obtained phenoxide ion is stable. The reason is due to resonance. Hence, phenols are more acidic than alcohol. Please note it down. This is the order with respect to different functional groups. Carboxylic acids are more acidic than carbonic acid. Carbonic acids are more acidic than phenols. Phenols are more acidic than water. Water is more acidic than alcohol, except methanol. For this, I have given the reason already. Go through that video. Now, coming to the effect of substituent group on the acidity of phenol. There are two types of substituting groups are there. One is electron withdrawing groups. Another one is electron donating group. Electron withdrawing groups. Whenever the electron withdrawing groups is directly bonded to the benzene ring, it exhibits two types of electronic effects. The first one is negative inductive effect. Since benzene is a conjugated molecule, therefore they also exhibit negative resonance effect. Whenever an electron withdrawing group is directly bonded to the benzene ring, it exhibits two types of effects. One is negative inductive effect, another one is negative resonance effect, which is directly proportional to the acidic nature of phenol. Means electron withdrawing group increases the acidic nature of phenol. The reason is due to negative inductive effect or due to negative resonance effect. What happens whenever the electron withdrawing group is bonded to the sp2 carbon atom of the benzene ring? It decreases the electron density on OH bond. It decreases the electron density on OH bond and hence release of H plus ion becomes very easy. Therefore, the acidic nature of phenols also increases. A few examples we can give. NO2, नाइट्रो ग्रुप, नाइट्रो ग्रुप, एल्डिहाइड ग्रुप, एल्डिहाइड ग्रुप, कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड ग्रुप, साइनाइड ग्रुप एक्सेट्रा. नाउ कमिंग टू रिलेटिव एसिड स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ नाइट्रोफिनॉल्स, रिलेटिव एसिड स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ नाइट्रोफिनॉल्स. नाइट्रो ग्रुप, दिस इज पैरा नाइट्रोफिनॉल, ऑर्थो नाइट्रोफिनॉल, मेटा नाइट्रोफिनॉल, पैरा नाइट्रोफिनॉल, ऑर्थो नाइट्रोफिनॉल एंड मेटा नाइट्रोफिनॉल एंड इट इज फिनॉल. इफ आई रिप्रेजेंट द डिक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर, पैरा नाइट्रोफिनॉल, पैरा नाइट्रोफिनॉल इज मोर एसिडिक दैन ऑर्थो नाइट्रोफिनॉल विच इज मोर एसिडिक दैन मेटा नाइट्रोफिनॉल एंड ऑल दीज थ्री आर मोर एसिडिक दैन फिनॉल. द रीजन इज ऑल दीज थ्री कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ फिनॉल possess electron withdrawing group like nitro group. If electron withdrawing groups are present on the benzene ring of phenol, then they are more acidic than phenols. So now the question arises, why para nitro phenol is more acidic than ortho nitro phenol, or why ortho nitro phenol is less acidic compared to para nitro phenol? I can represent it in terms of resonating structure of phenoxyanions, O minus, nitrogen, double bond O, O. So this is para nitro phenoxyanion. Now this electrons will come, this electron will come here because it is an electron withdrawing group. Minus R effect will be greater than minus I effect, therefore delocalization of electron takes place. We'll get one more resonating structure like this, double bond. Negative charge, double bond O, N, double bond O, O. Now this negative charge will come here and will get accumulated at this position. Get this type of resonating structure, double bond O minus N, double bond O, O. This negative charge will come here and it will come here. We get one more resonating structures, double bond O, double bond, nitrogen, O minus O. Again we'll come back, will move here and this electrons will come here at this structure. Now minus double bond O, N double bond O. Finally the electrons move into their respective positions. Double bond, double bond, double bond, NO2, O minus. Why nitrophenols is more acidic than normal phenols? Because if you observe in case of normal phenoxyanion, the normal phenoxyanion, normal phenoxyanion, normal phenoxyanion has an ability to form only 5 resonating structures. Normal phenoxyanion can form only 5 resonating structure, where here this is a nitrophenols, nitrophenoxyanion. Nitrophenoxyanion has an ability to form total 6 resonating structures. Greater the number of resonating structures, greater will be the stability. As number of resonating structures increases, as number of resonating structure increases, stability also increases. As stability increases, acidic property also increases. Due to this, nitrophenols are more acidic than normal phenols. Nitrophenols are more acidic than normal phenols because We can observe in this case of nitro phenoxidan, we are getting total 6 resonating structures, but in case of normal phenoxidan, we are getting only 5 resonating structures. Therefore, nitrophenols are more acidic than normal phenols. Please note it down. But here the question is, why orthonitrophenols is less acidic compared to paranitrophenol? Now, if I represent orthonitrophenoxidan, O minus, here it will be N O double bond O. Okay. Means both, you can observe, if this negative charge present on the oxygen atom undergo delocalization, both ortho and para nitrophenols, both ortho and para nitrophenols has an ability to form totally 6 resonating structures. So the number of resonating structures in case of para phenoxidan as well as in case of ortho phenoxidan will be same. So depend on this concept, I cannot explain why ortho nitrophenol is less acidic compared to para nitrophenol. But based on hydrogen bonding, I can clearly give the exact reason why ortho nitrophenol is less acidic than para nitrophenol. So this oxygen atom is more electronegative, therefore it carries partial negative charge, it carries partial positive charge. Nitrogen and oxygen. Oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen, therefore it carries partial negative charge. This nitrogen atom carries positive charge, and the more electronegative oxygen atom involved in the weak force of attraction with hydrogen atom. And this type of bond is called as hydrogen bond. This bond exists within the molecule. The hydrogen bond exists within the molecule, therefore it is called as intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Due to the formation of intramolecular hydrogen bonding, release of this proton becomes difficult. Release of proton becomes difficult compared to para nitrophenol. Therefore, ortho nitrophenols are less acidic compared to para nitrophenol. Please note it down. Now, the next question is, why meta nitrophenols are less acidic compared to para nitrophenol? Why meta nitrophenols are less acidic compared to para as well as ortho nitrophenol? The simple reason is, if the nitrogen atom is bonded at metacarbon atom, if the nitro group is bonded at the meta position in the benzene ring, it exhibit only minus I effect. It exhibit only minus I effect because delocalization of electrons does not takes place within the benzene ring, but this delocalization cannot possible with the nitro group when it is present at meta position. If the nitro group is present at meta position, delocalization may not possible on the nitro group. Therefore, if nitro group is present at meta position, it exhibit only negative inductive effect but not resonance effect, whereas ortho and para exhibits greater resonance effect as well as minus I effect. Due to greater resonance effect, ortho and para are more acidic when compared to meta nitrophenols. But metanitrophenol is more acidic than normal phenol. Metanitrophenol is more acidic than normal phenol due to the presence of electron with a drawing group. Please note it down. Next question is, ऑर्थोनाइट्रोफिनॉल पोसेस लेस बॉइलिंग पॉइंट, ऑर्थोनाइट्रोफिनॉल्स पोसेस लेस बॉइलिंग पॉइंट कंपेयर टू पैरानाइट्रोफिनॉल. Why orthonitrophenol possesses less boiling point than paranitrophenol? The very simple answer is, this is paranitrophenol. Here, this OH group has an ability to form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with one more phenol. And this has an ability to form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with one more nitrophenol. It has an ability to form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with one more nitrophenol. But here, this hydrogen atom involved in the formation of intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Here, what type of bonding? This one, intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, so due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding exist in paranitrophenol, each molecule is accumulated with three other nitrophenols. Due to this, accumulation of molecules takes place. Hence, their molecular mass increases. As soon as the molecules start accumulating with each other together, their molecular mass increases. In turn, the boiling point also increases. But in this case, this OH bond is involved in the formation of intramolecular hydrogen bonding with the nitro group present within the molecule. Neither nitro group nor OH group has an ability to form hydrogen bonding with other orthonitrophenols. Therefore, it becomes more volatile compound. Due to the intermolecular hydrogen bonding and possesses less boiling point compared to paranitrophenol. Simple, we can give the information like this. In orthonitrophenol, due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding, accumulation of other phenol molecules is not possible. But in case of paranitrophenol, due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding, accumulation of other phenol molecules is possible. Hence, paranitrophenol possesses greater boiling point than orthonitrophenol. Orthonitrophenol is less soluble in water when compared to para and metanitrophenol. Solubility of nitrophenols in water. Give reason. The reason is very simple. In case of orthonitrophenols, we can observe the formation of intramolecular hydrogen bonding within the molecule. But in case of meta as well as para, this OH group is free. The OH group exists in meta as well as para, is free and has an ability to form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water. But due to the presence of intramolecular hydrogen bonding in case of orthonitrophenol, there is no free OH group. Therefore, the solubility of Orthonitrophenone is very less when compared to meta as well as paranitrophenol. Please note it down. Coming to next, effect of electron donating groups on the acidic nature of phenol. When electron donating groups bonded to the sp2 carbon atom of benzene ring in phenols, they increases the electron density on the benzene ring. As soon as the electron density on the benzene ring increases because of positive resonance effect, or they can also exhibit plus psi effect, the acidic nature of phenol decreases. The acidic nature of phenol decreases. The electron donating groups exhibit positive resonance effect and negative positive inductive effect. Due to this, the acidic nature of phenol decreases. The reason is electron donating groups increases electron density on OH bond and decreases the stability of phenoxide ion. Decreases the stability of phenoxide ion by donating the electrons. Hence, release of H plus becomes slightly difficult. Release of H plus ion becomes slightly difficult due to this. Electron donating groups always decreases the acidic nature of phenols. Please note it down. Relative acidic strength of crazols. Phenol is more acidic than metacrazole. Metacrazole is more acidic than paracresol, and paracresol is more acidic than orthocresol. The reason is simple. Why phenol is more acidic than these three means because of these three molecule contains electron donating groups always decreases. Electron donating groups decreases stability of phenoxide ion. In turn, acidic nature of phenols also get decreases. Therefore, phenol is more acidic than when compared to other crazols. Now the question is, metacrazols are more acidic than para as well as orthocrazol. I need to explain, or I need to give the simple reason for this question. The reason is very simple. If CH3, that is electron donating group, present at meta position, it exhibit only plus psi effect. And you can observe here, from the OH group, the CH3 group present far away. Therefore, plus psi effect will be minimum. And there is no plus R effect. But in both these cases, plus R effect will be there. Due to the resonance effect, electron density on the OH group becomes more and more. Therefore, these two, para and orthocrazols, are less acidic when compared to metacrazole. Very simple reason is, in case of metacrazole, the CH3 group exhibit only plus psi effect. Whereas in case of ortho and para, plus R effect will be maximum. Therefore, ortho and paracrazols are less acidic when compared to metacrazole. Now, one more question arises. Why ortho is least acidic when compared to para? Para exhibit plus R as well as plus psi effect. It also exhibit plus R as well as plus psi effect. Both exhibit plus R as well as plus psi, plus R as well as plus psi. But in case of orthochrysal, in case of orthochrysal, the electron donating group present very near to the OH group. The electron donating group which is present very near to the OH group, therefore plus psi effect will be maximum. We know that inductive effect decreases as the number of carbon atoms increases between the substituent and the functional group. Here it is present on the second carbon atom. It is present far away from the carbon atom. Here it is far away. The OH group is present far away from the electron donating group, but here the OH group present on the adjacent carbon atom of electron donating group. Due to positive inductive effect, electron density on the OH group becomes more and more when compared to the parachrysal. Therefore, orthochrysals are less acidic when compared to parachrysals. Please note it down. Coming to the next, relative acidic strength of methoxyphenol. Methoxy group means OCH3 group. This OCH3 group exhibit two types of effects on the benzene ring. The first one is plus R effect, that is electron donating group. It acts as electron donating group when it is bonded to the conjugated molecule. And it also exhibit minus I effect, electron withdrawing group. Due to the presence of oxygen atom, it also exhibit minus I effect, electron withdrawing group. When both the groups acting on the same molecule, when both the effects acting on the same molecule, then plus R effect will be more powerful when compared to minus I effect. Plus R effect will be more effective when compared to minus I effect. Methoxy group acts as exhibit two effects, positive resonance effect as well as negative inductive effect. If both the effects acting on the same molecule, then always plus R effect overrides the negative inductive effect. Now I'll come to back relative acidic strength of methoxyphenol. It will be like this: OCH3 methoxyphenol. Methoxyphenol is more acidic than normal phenol, which is more acidic than ortho which is more acidic than para methoxyphenol. So this is the relative acidic strength of methoxyphenol. Please note it down. Now first question arises: why methoxyphenol is more acidic than normal phenol? The very simple reason is, if this OCH3 group is bonded at meta position, if this OCH3 group is bonded at meta position, it exhibit only negative inductive effect. It exhibit only negative inductive effect, and there is no resonance effect. So OH in this methoxyphenol, OCH3 acts as electron withdrawing groups because of negative inductive effect. Hence methoxyphenol is more acidic than normal phenol. Now, second question is, why orthomethoxyphenol and paramethoxyphenols are less acidic than normal phenol? Because in these two cases, this OCH3 group exhibit both plus R effect as well as plus I effect. Since the plus R effect predominates over plus I effect, therefore paramethoxyphenol as well as orthomethoxyphenols are less acidic than phenol or less acidic than phenol. So between orthomethoxyphenol and paramethoxyphenol, orthomethoxyphenol is more acidic than paramethoxyphenol. The reason we should have to find out. In both the cases, OH3 exhibit positive resonance effect as well as minus I effect, and plus R effect always predominates over minus I effect. So based on this concept, we can explain that both methoxyphenol should have almost similar acidic strength, but you can observe in case of orthomethoxyphenol, this methoxy group is a bulky group and this OH group is also a bulky group. The OH group is also a bulky. If two bulky groups are in the same plane, then automatically the one bulky group changes its position in the plane. So it will be towards us now and it will be away from us, OCH3. It will change the plane. As soon as when two bondings are in different plane, we know that resonance effect decreases. It indicates this. In this case, minus I effect predominates over plus R effect. As minus I effect predominates over plus R effect, automatically the acidic nature of methoxyphenol increases. In this case, both OH group as well as OCH3 group present far away from each other. Hence, plus R effect will predominate over minus I effect. Due to this, paramethoxyphenol is less acidic than orthomethoxyphenol. Okay, students. I think you have been understood the class today. The acidic nature of phenol plays a very important role for your any type of objective level examination. So be perfect with these concepts. In the next class, I am going to continue the concepts of phenol. Thank you for watching the video. If you like this video, please subscribe for more videos. Thank you and have a nice day.